space for that. Impossible. I can't carry anymore.
Thank you.
full up. Can't carry anymore. I can't carry anymore. Impossible. I can't carry anymore. Enough space for that. All full up. Can't carry anymore. Thank you. Within lies Rally Rimmel, friend, 1925. There's a little more. Beware, traps ahead. No one's been through here in years. May Remax be the first voice we hear in the afterlife. And may her stories comfort us. All full up. Can't carry anymore. This skull is deformed, flatter and longer than what we consider normal. Some people believe this is evidence the Inca were contacted by extraterrestrials, but it's more likely the result of headbinding, a human practice of deformation so ancient it predates written history. It also has evidence of trepanation, a medical procedure in which a hole is carved in the skull. impossible. I can't carry anymore. I should be able to reach the sarcophagus now. Shit, I'll have to keep climbing. The heathen emperor begged for his life to be spared. He offered the Spanish crown a room of 3x6 varas to be filled once over with gold and twice with silver. The crown, with great and undue benevolence, accepted this offer. Within 2 months, the ransom had been paid. The idolater, however, could not be trusted. When the cursed plans of his general surprise attack were exposed, Atahualpa fell to his knees, begging for mercy. His fate would be decided by fair trial, as the right of any man in the Spanish Empire. He was found guilty and sentenced to die, but before the execution, he accepted the Lord and will be welcomed in the heavens above. excerpt from an objective account of Pizarro in Peru by Ochoa Aceves.
Thank you. special for her birthday.
Silly. Nah. I think it's a great idea. She's done so much for this town. It'll give everyone a break.
I was thinking maybe a cake.
Where are we going to get a cake?
Make one?
Okay. I'm putting you in charge of that.
Omar.
Uh-huh?
They've been working all night.
And? Isn't that what they're paid for? Get lost.
It's unsafe.
Oh shit. No.
Now fuck off and let me watch the damn game.
What is that?
Sure would be great to get these thieves out of here.
Everything all right?
No. It's all terrible, as usual. These pillagers come to town, hire us to dig up our own relics, don't even pay us a living wage.
And then they run off with them and profit.
We are all desperate here. There's no work since poor Veneer pulled out. We're sitting ducks.
And I imagine the storm hasn't helped matters.
The little we had is gone or underwater. I don't know what to do anymore.
I have some experience with these kinds of people. Maybe I can help.
I don't know what good it'll do. Did I catch your name?
Lara.
I'm Victor. If you want to talk to Omar, the executive lead tormentor in charge of theft and pillaging, he's in there.
Thanks.
Be careful. He doesn't like to be challenged.
Piss off.
Who are you? Looking for work?
Well, you're out of luck. We have enough people. Marco's in charge of HR now anyway.
Yes, thank you. Do you know where he is?
Where else? The bar.
Sure would be great to get these thieves out of here.
I can't carry any more.
Two years have been working up to never to ask her out. I finally do. And now, who is that guy anyway?
I'm looking for Marco.
Why? For what?
I just want to talk to him.
He doesn't want any trouble.
I'm not looking for trouble. I'm looking for work.
Work? Oh, yeah. Yeah, sure.
So, you're Marco?
Tell me Omar didn't send you here to mess with me. If any of those animals hurts my son.
Marco, I'm not with Omar. Believe me. What's this about your son?
I blew out my knee, so Omar took Pablo to replace me at the dig site. Said I was HR now and that it was my job to find a replacement. Otherwise,
he'd keep working your son.
Yeah. I'm worried he's just gonna keep Pablo up there, even if I bring him someone.
Well, it's a good thing you've just hired someone.
You? Really? You do that?
We wouldn't want to disappoint the boss, would we?
Thank you. If you see Pablo, please tell him I'm here.
New here, eh? Get used to doing a lot of nothing. Although drinking and sweating helps to break up the day.
You're not a local?
No, I work a ship that blew into some rocks just outside town. Storm came out of nowhere, sunk the damn thing.
I can't thank you enough for doing this.
I don't know how they can gossip so cheerfully when we've lost so much.
I'm sorry.
Wait, you're not Mariela.
No, I'm just, so sorry to bother you.
I've got some stuff to trade if you're looking.
How are you?
See anything that you like? Excellent choice. A good deal for both of us. Enjoy. Excellent choice. Enjoy. Excellent choice. Enjoy. Excellent choice. I'm always ready to do business. Did you hear? They're forcing our kids to work now.
Poor Pablo, I heard.
We should do something. Those guys pushed Marco so hard, he can barely walk.
If we don't do something, it'll only get worse. Haven't seen you around here before.
I just got in, but I won't be staying long.
Don't let how it looks fool you. This is a good place. Difficult, but good.
Your garden seems to survive the storm.
Luck and hard work. A lot of people pitched in to grow it, so they all came to protect it, too.
Miss Ortiz, thank you for your recent inquiry. A water quality index, WQI, was calculated for river sites surrounding the village of Kuakyaku from the samples you provided, and results have shown that the river sites should be classified as bad water quality. The results of the study have shown large-scale impacts that include siltation, chemical pollution, and heavy metal pollution. Turbidity and total solids exceeded the environmental limits. Water of high turbidity, hazy, murky water, cannot be used as potable water, and the high total solids also imply that it cannot be used as irrigation water as well, as this will damage infrastructure. It is most likely that any subsistence fishing that took place before is no longer possible at the affected river sites, thereby impacting negatively on people's livelihoods. Similarly, pH was in the high alkaline range, as well as COD. These parameters were indicative of some chemical pollution in the river. The pH, that is alkaline, hard water, is corrosive and can damage plumbing equipment and clothes. High levels of fluoride in the water poses the risk of diseases such as dental and skeletal fluorosis. The presence of pathogenic bacteria such as Salmonella also represents an immediate health risk for the local community. I don't have enough space for that. Impossible. I can't carry any more. This is a dedication to Supe, god of death and ruler of Ukupasha, the Incan underworld. It entreats him to come forth with his legions of demons and to converge on this site, where the local people will do him honor with written poems extolling his greatness or offerings of food and drink. By paying him the respect he deserves in this way, the local people pray he will only take those he must, and not harm any others of their community unnecessarily. Are you okay?
You're coming after me?
Are you Pablo?
Yes.
It's okay. Your father sent me. He's at Abby's. Go meet him there. I'll take care of these guys.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Get out of here. I can't carry anymore.
This and justice that. Wow, wow, wow.
Fucking snowflake.
Are the fines here even worth it? They are on the black market.
True. Almost 100% markup. Whatever we get for them.
Thank you.
get back to the village. All full up. Can't carry any more. Gather your things. I go back to the village.
Thank you.
Bless you.
Impossible. I can't carry any more. This knife is a cheap plastic replica of those traditionally used to sacrifice llamas in the Inti Raymi or Sun God Festival. It was also occasionally used to perform trepanning surgery. The Inca believed that cutting a hole in the skull could relieve pressure to cure some diseases.
have enough space for that.
Running toward Abby's.
Haven't seen you around here before.
I just got in, but I won't be staying long.
Don't let how it looks fool you. This is a good place. Difficult, but good.
Your garden seems to have survived the storm.
Luck and hard work. A lot of people pitched in to grow it, so they all came to protect it, too.
Impossible. I can't carry anymore.
This village was once under the wing and watchful eye of the Condor, but we let the Eagle chase her away.
I'm not sure I understand.
Neither do I. We lost ourselves in our pursuit of things, thought we'd be happier with coins in our pockets, but the Eagle took that away as well.
I don't have enough space for that.
Thank you.
Someone has barricaded the path. Impossible. I can't carry anymore. May Waiter's desire for power be sated by the time we follow him to the afterlife. Looks like the bridge is out. This room has fared better than the rest of the cavern, it seems.
I know it sounds silly giving you
Pilar, you promised her.
Abigail is stupid. I'm sorry, do I know you?
Sorry, I didn't realize this was a private residence.
Gosh, we lost a lot, but I didn't realize it was that bad.
I really didn't mean to.
I know you didn't, but if you'll excuse us, we have a lot of work to do.
Bet you've never seen anything like this, huh? This is my last one. Sold the rest to that commander fella. He was a little intense, but hey, he bought all my stock, didn't he? Well, except this one. Runs smooth, never breaks down. It's a real beaut, isn't it? No, I'm serious. My wife here, she hasn't been the same since the accident. But the gentle hum, it helps her relax.
I'm glad. Space for that. Miss Ortiz, your dedication and commitment to the village of Kwakyaku is commendable. However, Poor Veneer does not accept your charges of responsibility for the terrible state of the village. In fact, the Board of Executives has decided, and your local government representative agrees, if you continue this crusade of slandering our good name, we will have no choice but to take legal action. From the office of Roberto Lavia, Chief Executive Officer, Poor Veneer. All full up. Can't carry any more.
Always nice to see fresh faces in town. Good for the mind to know that our little corner of the world isn't forgotten. Also good for the wallet, if you'd maybe take a look at what we have for sale up at the general store.
I love old maps. When I was a little girl, they always led to treasure.
They always make me feel more lost.
My name's Lara, by the way.
Pilar. You don't look like the type of tourists we usually get.
I'm an archaeologist, actually.
Yes. That would be more fitting, I think. You should speak with Abigail. She knows the history of this place better than almost anyone.
We've already met. Abby's been kind enough to let my friend and I stay with her while we're visiting.
Ah. Well then, you are a welcomed guest in Kuakyaku.
Thank you. Do you need help understanding the map?
It wasn't meant for me to understand.
I have hidden the truth, as Abigail will find, but to uncover it, she must take a trip back in time.
Mariana was never much of a poet.
Mariana?
Abigail's grandmother. We lost her to cancer 1 year ago today, actually.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Mariana wanted Abigail to have the map on the anniversary of her death, but...
You're not sure.
I don't know if she's ready.
It's none of my business, but if it helps, Mariana believes she was.
Nah. You're right. I guess it never was my decision, was it? Would you mind delivering the map to Abigail? You could make a full-time job of chasing that girl around, and my hips just won't have it.
Not at all. Abby's grandmother wanted her to have this, but why? Pilar didn't seem to know. It has to have something to do with the riddle she wrote on the back. I have hidden the truth, as Abigail will find, but to uncover it, she must take a trip back in time. Abby, it's Lara.
Hey, stranger. How are you making out? How's Jonah?
Jonah's fine. He's with a friend.
A friend, huh? What's her name?
His name is Uchu. Listen, Abby, I'm back in Kuakyaku, and I've come across an old map that belonged to your grandmother.
Well, there's an old-timer in town, Diego. He runs the community garden. He's into maps, I think. Maybe he can take a look. Meet me there?
On my way.
¿Cómo te fue hoy? Estuviste tomando muestras de su...
Sí, en mi mente.
averiado ese alternador?
Sí. Ya cargué las piezas en el avión.
All full up. Can't carry anymore. Traditionally woven from fabric and stuffed with reeds and grains, the burial dolls are frequently shown holding something in their hand, like a musical instrument or a ball of yarn. In this instance, the doll is holding a toddler, perhaps signifying that the deceased was a mother. But this one is made from modern materials. I suppose Paul Vanier could have made it as a promotional toy.
Oye, ¿te pasa algo a Adam?
I don't have enough space for that.